The kings of Bavaria once ruled in Munich, but now it's figure skating's elite who will be crowned. Tonight, it's the ladies skating for their place among the world's best on the way to the Olympic Games, all led by the world champion, America's Tara Lipinski. At just 15, if Tara is to confirm her world's win last year with Olympic success, the place to start is here, and the time is now. But the best of the rest share the same ambitions, including Germany's own Tanya Shevchenko. This season, she competes with the gift of life. All the ladies here on Munich's Olympic Hall ice would like to capture the early lead in this season of gold. In pairs, two can become one in a ballet of power. This discipline also has a German story. Wutzel and Steuer themselves the world champs. This year, their goal is to turn their nightmare of Olympics past into their dreams of gold. But in pairs, the tradition and the history belongs to Russia. Artur Dmitriev hopes to keep his own medal streak alive, but with a new partner, Oksana Kazakova. But their rinkmates, Yelena Berezhnaya and Anton Zikralitsia, are riding speed, elegance, and grace right toward the very same podium. Never has the Champions Finals meant so much. As this is the last time the world's best skaters can take their measure before they step out onto Olympic ice. Champions Finals. Hi everyone, I'm Susie Culver. Just 7 weeks and counting until the Olympic Games, and you can feel the temperature rising, especially right here and now, because there's only one competition remaining that gives the best figure skaters in the world a clear-cut picture of where they stand, and this is it, one last chance to go head-to-head. Tonight's focus is on the ladies and the pairs, and in those two departments, we surely have you covered. Want to know a little something about what it's like to stand up to the pressure in an Olympic season? Ask Peter Carruthers. He won silver in pairs, and Dorothy Hamill, who won gold not too far from here. And Dorothy, when you want to talk ladies, you have to start with the defending world champ.
Absolutely. Tara Lipinski. It's hard to believe that less than a year ago, Tara Lipinski took the international skating scene by storm. She came in as just another young figure skater and ended up becoming world champion. And with all the pressures that becoming a world champion can put on you, Tara has proved that she has the guts and the desire to do what it takes. While her season hasn't been perfect up to this point, she's come here, she is the defending champion, and she plans to keep it that way. She's challenged by Russia's Maria Butyrskaya, who's always looking for a medal, with her mature and artistic style. And Germany's own Tanya Shevchenko, who was out all last season with major medical problems. She's looking to continue her strong comeback this season in front of her home German crowd. And Peter, I can tell you how enthusiastic these German crowds can be.
I remember that very well, and I can tell you that the German fans are also going to push through the free program two of their own countrymen. They're the defending world champions, and really everybody is chasing them. But there are two exceptional Russian teams here, coached by the guru of pairs figure skating, Tamara Moskvina, the first, Berezhnaya and Zikralitsia. They've only been together for a year and a half, but what they have going for them is their great speed. It's amazing to see in such short time that they've been together. Then there's Kazakova and Dmitriev. They've only been together for 3 years, so they are outstanding. They always skate with so much intensity, and they push the envelope with their originality. I really think that if all the teams skate to the best level that they can, we're going to see pair skating go to a new level in this competition.
And you know a little something about battling this Russian.
I sure do.
Well, let's let the suspense build and begin with the ladies, Tara Lipinski's short program.
Next up, representing the United States of America, Tara Lipinski.
15-year-old Tara Lipinski is the defending world, U.S., and series finals champ. Michelle Kwan wrestled a win away from her in the first event of the series, and she was upset in Paris in a trying season.
I'll tell you, though, 15-year-old young lady, she has wonderful expression.
Serpentine spiral. She's got beautiful extension, nice line, good flow. She uses these moves to get warmed up, unlike most of the skaters who come out and do the jumps first, the difficult jumps first to get warmed up.
And that's smart, because the first difficult combination for her, the triple Lutz, double loop, the first one, second one, no problem.
Triple flip, just perfect. Clean takeoff, clean landing, great position in the air.
Totally effortless.
She's skating so confidently.
Double axel, actually a little bit improved over last year because she's starting to get her free leg through a little better. That is the foot that's off the ice on the takeoff. I'll tell you one thing, I couldn't do that at 15 years old. It was remarkable.
You know, I toured with her all summer, and she is the most consistent skater I've ever seen. She never misses that triple Lutz.
She genuinely looked like she was having fun out there tonight.
Sure did. And here's the Lutz combo. Here's a bit of a controversy here. See how she changes edge into back inside edge. But sometimes the judges pick up on that, and sometimes they don't.
And then this triple flip, so easy for her.
Tara's marks for acquired elements, this usually her strong suit.
Well, I actually think that in these required elements marks, we are seeing she's taking a hit for that wrong edge takeoff on the triple Lutz.
Yes, she is, a little bit.
1 to 3/10 deduction on that. It depends upon what the judge thinks and how severe it is.
And she has worked so hard to improve her presentation.
And you can see the marks clearly come up here. It was a beautiful program, choreographed by Sandra Bezzo. And last year, Peter, those are the marks that were not as high as her technical marks.
True.
One of the top ladies in the world is not here. Michelle Kwan, the inaugural series champion, has had her Olympic season sidetracked. After an uncharacteristic mistake at Skate Canada, Michelle learned that the pain felt in her left foot was a stress fracture in a toe that affected her ability to take off on jumps. Her foot was placed in a cast for 2 weeks, forcing Michelle to miss the series' final regular season event.
She still managed to qualify for a trip to the finals here in Munich, but had to withdraw. For Michelle Kwan, her sights are now set on Nagano this February, where she still has to be considered one of the favorites for Olympic gold. Up next, one of the most heartwarming and dramatic comebacks in skating continues right here. And later, Tanya Shevchenko's teammates, the defending world champs, Wutzel and Stoyer, take the ice for pairs competition. They'll be facing off with the hottest Russians on ice. Bereznaya and Zikor Alitsia will make your heart melt. Don't miss it. We're back from Germany in a flash. Munich, the capital of the German region of Bavaria, is also its heart of history and culture with beginnings that go back 1,200 years. But in this Olympic season, we must remember that not that long ago, Munich played host to the 1972 Summer Games. Here in this same Olympia Halle, a young Russian gymnast named Olga Korbut charmed the world. Also in the same hall in 1991, U.S. figure skaters made history as well, as Christy Yamaguchi led an American sweep of the World Figure Skating Championships. Now this is sure to be a face-off. Tara Lipinski, the defending world champ, but with so many expectations, she has placed second twice this season. Meantime, Tanya Shevchenko, just happy to be on the ice, has been the surprise of the series. Ladies figure skating was suffering a void. Tanya Shevchenko suffered in silence. The angel on ice was a prisoner in a personal hell. A mysterious disease had her virtually paralyzed with exhaustion. How could this happen? Tanya seemed destined for greatness. At just 16, she was already the world's bronze medalist.
I always say that skating is it's like heaven on earth. So I think that that I'm the only one at the moment who knows what it means to be a figure skater and to love figure skating.
Imagine that love was ripped from her grasp. In September of 96, she could barely climb two stairs, let alone skate. She was a 19-year-old with a life-threatening disease. Finally diagnosed as a combination of viruses, she began cell therapy. Each Friday, Tanya and her mother would travel from Dortmund to Munich for blood transfusions.
I was scared and I didn't know what's going on, and when I felt really bad, I thought, oh, that's like dying.
Tanya could not practice for a year. When she finally returned to the ice, it was just 30 minutes at a time. It would be a long road. But after 19 months away from competition, she made her return this season. Adding to the drama, her first event was on German ice. Her performance, miraculous.
When I saw that I'm first, I started crying. And I kissed my coach and said thank you, and then we both cried, and that was the best feeling I ever had.
But there was more to come. A month later, she repeated her performance with a win in Japan. Tanya Shevchenko, more graceful than ever, was back as one of the best.
At the beginning of the season, I was just happy that I can skate again, and for me it was not important which place or what, how I skate, but it was important that I skate. So, and I didn't thought that I can win, and so now I won 3 times, and that's unbelievable.
Well, let's see if it gets more unbelievable as the rest of the ladies field guns for Tara Lipinski. First up, Irina Slutskaya.
And in a world full of hot young teenagers, I remember a few years ago when this one absolutely charmed us. She really struggled this time with her jumps. She finished a disappointing 4th place, and she knew it.
Tanya Shevchenko came into this competition sick. The throat was sore. There were problems right from the beginning in the short program. The triple lutz, one of the biggest in ladies figure skating, did not work the night of the short program. But then again, how can you perform at your best when you just don't feel good?
And Maria Butyrskaya at 25 brings a maturity to the sport. In the past, she's had a problem putting it all together. But she did put it all together here in the short program. And this being an Olympic year, this is the time to do it.
Hey, Tara, watch out. So here's how it stands after the short. Lipinski in first, Butyrskaya in second. Shevchenko, who last week won the German national championship but was left exhausted, will really have to rally. The fourth member of our team, two-time national ice dance champ Susie Wynn, is backstage with the leader.
Tara, earlier in the season, you had two losses. Now, going out into this competition, you probably were a little nervous, but you didn't look nervous at all out there.
No, I felt very confident, and in the beginning of the season, I was, you know, I felt confident too, but I feel like now I'm peaking, and I'm getting to that point where I was last year, and I think also winning last year gave me a lot of confidence here to say, you know, I was the champion, and I can do it again, so...
Now, we've talked a lot about presentation. Those are exactly the marks that are high right now. How does that feel?
That feels great. I mean, my technical, you know, it was great. And, you know, when the marks go up after that, it's even better because I've worked so hard this year on that.
Best of luck in the free program. All righty.
Straight ahead, 92 Olympic champ Artur Dmitriev hopes he and his new partner, Oksana Kazakova, can strike gold. But their young Russian rivals may steal the show.
We wish you a Merry Christmas.
And a happy new year.
From Yelena
and Anton.
Hi, I'm Tara Lipinski. And with the Winter Olympics approaching, you can bet it's a pretty exciting time to be a skater. As you can imagine, becoming a champion isn't achieved alone. It also takes support and contributions from others. Chevy Cavalier is supporting Olympic hopefuls by awarding a convertible to the skater who receives the most perfect 6 scores at the Nationals. The Winter Games is every skater's dream. It's great to have the folks at Cavalier behind us. Thanks, Chevrolet.
Chevrolet, a proud sponsor of the United States Figure Skating Association.
Back with you from Germany. Glad you're on board for the Prime Star Champions Finals. Grab a seat because the race is on. Russian coach Tamara Moskvina, a former skater herself, has no problem staying fit. She has two pairs competing here in Munich. Kazakova and Dmitriev, and Berezhnaya Zikorelitsia. The former are up first in the pair short program.
Oksana Kazakova, Artur Dmitriev.
Just seeing Oksana Kazakova and Artur Dmitriev here is a surprise. They had to pull out of their second series event because of injury, and they slipped into the field here after Marina Yeltsva and Andrei Bushkov withdrew. Late notice meant visa troubles. They got here the night before competition.
Right away, they start off with total conviction when they're skating. They'll need it to follow through on these side-by-side triple toe loops. Very nice.
Strong. He's just so strong.
Check the unison. Right on.
These two have been skating together for just a short time, a couple of years. And every year I see such an improvement. They really skate like a pair now, together.
And they have done well.
Quite nice considering just Tuesday they didn't even know they were going to be here.
I'll tell you, that last minute notice is tough to take, but they've really handled the pressure well.
For the side-by-side triple toe loops. Good reach, good positions in the air, terrific unison.
And this split double twist lift, pretty good height. Watch how he catches her. A very nice catch and set down. They've improved that a lot. And what I like so much about this lift is it starts out in a basic press and then it rolls over. He'll transfer his weight to the right arm, and look at the position there. Very difficult to do an original.
And the marks for Oksana Kazakova and Artur Dmitriev.
These are all fairly strong marks. Consistent when you consider there's only 1/10 between 5-6 and 5-7.
For presentation.
Well, it's that excitement that they create when they skate that brings this presentation mark up, in my opinion.
Representing Russia, Elina Bershaya, Anton Chikovolite.
The young Russian couple, Yelena Berezhnaya and Anton Zikorlidze, have had a tremendous season. Second in Germany, first in France, where they beat the defending world champs. Confidence-wise, they really needed that to quiet any doubters. See if they can keep it up.
Triple toe loops. He's been having a bit of a problem struggling with this in practice this week.
Ooh.
Touched down his foot.
You have got to be out of this world if you're going to skate to Swan Lake. They are. Look at that. Fantastic.
Just seem to float over the ice to me. You don't see any scratches. They're really magnificent. Thank you.
with Tamara Moskvina as the coach, you know that they'll finish with their combination spin. Always unique and different. Great positions throughout. I'm sold.
That was beautiful.
This definitely can make you melt.
They are such an attractive couple on the ice. That woman, Tamara Moskvina, largely responsible for all of it.
She knows how to bring out the best in them.
Now on these side-by-side triple toe loops, let's see if he touches his foot down. Yes, he does. That will be a 1-2/10 deduction.
And his huge split twist.
Puts her down like a feather, doesn't
delicately,
it?
Absolutely.
Back hand-to-hand press. Very original. She'll take her right leg and hook it onto his arm and then somersault.
And the marks for Berezhnaya and Zika Rulidze.
Well, I'm kind of surprised we see 5.8 all the way down to 5.3 for the first required elements mark. But in some cases, it looks like they've taken Kazakova and Dmitriev.
Less doubt when it comes to presentation.
Wow. These are outstanding marks.
It was a spectacular performance, but in this program, you can't miss any of the elements.
And that moves them ahead of Kazakova and Dmitriev. On the way, the defending series champs make their stand. Mandy Wutzel and her partner Ingo Stoyer look intense, but really, everybody's got the holiday spirit.
Season greetings.
And happy holidays.
As the worldwide federation for figure skating and speed skating on ice, the International Skating Union proudly showcases the flowing grace, the intense power, and the magnificent glory of worldwide competitive skating. The International Skating Union, bringing you champions since 1892.
The reigning world champs, Mandy Wutzel and Ingo Stoyer, you can hear the crowd. It's been tough for them to deal with distractions, injuries, less practice time than they're used to. They still managed to pull out a first place finish on their home turf, their first time out.
Side-by-side triple toes right off the top. Oh, that is a stamp of approval right there. Actually, not as high as some of the other teams, but there's really no deduction for that. We'll be right back. spin. Really being very competitive with the Russians here.
They still have the world championship look.
Well, that's going to be interesting because you have to compare that to the classic line of the Russians. Will that performance of Wurzel and Steuer take Berezhnaya and C. Kuruizi at this point?
Here, side by side, triple toe loops. And they both nail those solidly.
This didn't have the height that it could have. So there's no deduction there, but that might show up a little bit in the presentation mark, not in the required elements.
Oh, looks solid. Here are their marks for the required elements.
They are very solid from 5'6 all the way up to 5'9.
And for presentation.
What a way to start the competition in their home country like this. Very strong marks.
And the world champs are in first. Pair standings after the short program, the defending champs on top, but this is still anybody's game. We'll see the free skate later, but first, Susie Wynn has a preview of what's on tap from Munich Wednesday.
Thank you, Susie. The dance competition is going to be hot. We have some of the world's best ice dancers here competing in the series finals, including four-time U.S. national dance champions Liz Punselin and Jared Swallow. In their first event of the series, they took gold at Skate America, and then they went on to take silver at Skate Canada. So they're getting used to these medals, and finally, the international dance community is taking notice. Now, if they win a bronze medal here, this could give them a big boost going into the Olympic Games, and I certainly think it's a great possibility.
Well, Suze, bronze may be the only possibility because world champs Grishuk and Platov and Canadian champs Bourne and Kratz will be there too, and they are tough to beat. A star-studded men's field joins the best dance teams for the Prime Star Skate International Champions Finals, Christmas Eve, 8 p.m. Eastern and Pacific.
Frohe Weihnachten, ein gesundes neues Jahr und schöne Festtage.
Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.
Welcome back to the Olympiahalle here in Munich, Germany, and the Prime Star Champion Series final. No question, the pairs competition is the closest race here. Any of the top three can win, but going into the free skate, the defending world champs are holding their ground.
Well, the defending world champs are hoping for a lot of energy tonight, and the main thing for them is to stay settled within the performance because they are skating before their home country fans, Wurzel and Steuer. What I think they need to do is stay focused and not rush anything. In pair skating, it's paramount that the man not overthrow the girl on the very difficult throws. And Kazakova and Dmitriev, well, if you have Tamara Moskvina for a coach, you've got the upper hand. But for these two, now they need to really pull it together. Again, timing will be important, and to not hold back and really be aggressive in this performance.
And my favorites, Yelena Berezhnaya and Anton Zihorulica, they are what I call pure skaters. They skate with a classic elegance, no gimmicks. Notice their speed. I think they could actually take the whole thing if they skate well, even though they've been together for a year and a half.
Well, Dorothy, what's so remarkable about this team is what they've overcome to reach this point. Yelena suffered a serious head injury in 1996. With the help of her partner, they have fought back to become Russia's brightest stars. Their coach, Tamara Moskvina, believes that Yelena's near brush with death brought her even closer to her passion, skating.
When I look at them skating, and I think I must be like thankful that this girl if she will be my daughter. She is alive and she is doing what she wanted in her life, and it gives her happiness. And this is really a fairy tale that come true.
Quick recap of the standings after the short program. Baris Naya and Zikra Lidzia have to put down one of the best performances of their lives tonight if they hope to upset the world champs again. Remember, they beat them in France. Anton says his goal for their skating, high speed, huge elements. They've got that.
Yeah, they sure do. But they are extremely elegant and polished in the process.
Always up, her eyes are up, contrasted with low positions. She's really, they both are magnificent skaters. So pure.
Yelena says after 1 month on the ice, she forgot all about the accident, but Anton says that it took him all of last season to get over it, that he would be afraid when he lifted her what would happen if they fell.
Well, I'm going to go out on a limb, but we very well may be looking at the Olympic champions right here with that.
And can you believe only a year and a half skating together as a team?
Tamara Mosvina has given them all the tools they need.
To start off with a bang like this, look at the height on this split triple twist lift. Wonderful.
Throw triple salchow. Last year she had a spectacular fall. This year, perfect. Little bit on the inside edge, but beautiful.
And this throw triple loop, good follow through. What she's doing so well is holding on to the landings, whereas before she would fall.
They set the standard for the night. Stick around. The scores for Berezhnaya and Zika Ralitzia when we come right back. Welcome back to Munich and the scores for Berezhnaya and Zika Ralitzia.
Well, these are all very interesting technical merit scores. Remember, there are two teams to skate. So we see 5-8 and 1-5-7. They've left the window open.
And of course, the presentation marks do go up. I think the judges really appreciate their clean lines and their finesse. And no gimmicks, as I said before.
Their rink mates and rivals, Oksana Kazakova and Artur Dmitriev. When they are on, they have the best artistry of any pair. At season start, many believe this would be their time. It's been a three-year growing process. This being an Olympic year, time to make it work.
Kazakova and Dmitriev, trained by Tamara Mosvina. Artur has been more or less a big brother to Anton, but right now he is competing against him and he wants this triple toe loop with his partner. Oh. Getting it right back at the double axes though. Interesting because what we are seeing is a transition of the new generation coming in with Zika Ralitzia and Berezhnaya. Oh, wonderful throw. Making mistakes.
It's a changing of the guard, and how ironic. This is where he won his first world title in 1991.
Watching that lift, when you compare it to Berezhnaya and Zika Ralitzia, they are so fast and strong, and their youthful presence on the ice is outstanding. Here, the triple toe loop, almost a touchdown. However, they just don't have the energy Berezhnaya and Zika Ralitzia have. But they are great in their own way.
They are really the contrast in their styles, Peter. Zika Ralitzia and Berezhnaya are so classic and so pure. And these two are so innovative and they do such unusual moves. It's almost unfair to compare them.
Mm-hmm. Nice dismount out of that star lift. Layout position.
Here's an example of their unusual spins, positions they do, lifts.
So interesting to watch all of this unfold here at the finals before the Olympic Games. This competition means so much to the skaters because they know they are jockeying for position with the judges. Side by side, triple toe loops. Watch as Artur flips forward. She has trouble. It's not the way you want to start the free program.
Throw triple salchow. She gets good height, nice position in the air, and she manages to pull out of that one.
And again, that lunging forward, not able to accommodate the force coming down out of that high throw.
Lots of mistakes. See how tough the judges are on that.
Oh, and that's very clear right there. With five fives and five sixes, this is not what they want. Presentation a little bit better, but
pretty consistent.
No way can they catch Berezhnaya and Sika Ruizu with those marks.
You can never count out the defending series and world champs, Butzel and Stoyer, on their home turf when we come back. Here they are, the defending world champs, Mandy Wurzel and Ingo Stoyer. Their free program, the same as last year, like an old friend, and they need that security when little else has been going right. Distractions, injuries. They were very happy with their performance in the short. Everyone knows how much he struggled with those injuries.
What to look for in this performance? It's a wonderfully paced program.
Triple toe loops. Oh, very good. Off to a good start.
Leading the challenge.
And with the crowd behind you like this, it's gotta feel good.
everything on these throws. Triple toe loop. Only a double.
Shakes it out there. We're wondering if it's bothering him still.
Well, the reality is that when you're a pair skater, it's tough enough to skate a performance in singles, but when you're lifting a girl over your head, it's very taxing, and it was the right shoulder that was hit.
And as he said yesterday in practice, he broke the mirror on the car. But the mirror didn't break his arm, so I guess that's a lucky thing for his arm.
Element, the throw double axel. Oh, she landed it, but on 2 feet. A lot of tiny mistakes are adding up here. Well, they got through it, but I know that Ingo Stoyer has got to be thinking that, hey, we had a couple of mistakes too, so will that be enough to take them out of first place?
And here's the split triple twist. She doesn't get as much height as the Russian competitors.
On this overhead lift, he will transfer her weight to his right shoulder, and you can see her actually break a little bit right there. That jerk means it was out of position. It could be pain.
Mistakes added up.
5 sevens across the board with a 5-6 from the Chinese judge. It's pretty clear right here.
And getting an up close look at Ingo, it's pretty clear that he is in pain.
These marks will tell the story, though. Had there not been as many small mistakes, we would have seen the first mark more like this. We see a 5-9 from the German judge.
The score's just not good enough to hold off the young Russians, but give the Germans credit just for showing up here, considering all the adversity they've been through lately. So here's how the final standings look. What a future for Yelena and Anton. Keep an eye on them going for gold at the Olympics, and let's hope that Ingo has some time to regroup. What a great prelude to the games. Susie Wynn is backstage with the new champions.
Yelena and Anton, I love your skating. Congratulations. Now, you came in first in France, and now you're first here in Munich. How does this feel to be on the winner's podium?
Sure, we are very, very glad and very, very happy. And no questions.
All good things. Now, will you make any changes going into the Olympics in your programs?
I don't think so, because I think it's now we have good program and we don't change nothing.
Well, best of luck in Nagano. We'll be rooting for you.
Thank you.
Okay, congratulations.
And there was a ton of tremendous talent here in Munich, all wrapped up and looking for gold. U.S. champ Todd Eldridge, defending series and world champ Elvis Stoiko. We're saving the guys for Christmas Eve. That's Wednesday night, 8 Eastern and Pacific. When we come back this evening, it's the ladies' turn to sparkle. The Russian champion, the German champion, and the American champ face off. Don't go away.
Merry Christmas
and Happy New Year.
You from Munich, Germany, the Prime Star Champion Series final continues, and we are set for the ladies' free program. One of the most dramatic stories of the season continues to be Tanya Shevchenko, although the wave of success that got her here could be wiping her out.
Well, that's just it. She's got a lot of pressure on her to perform well in this competition. She's had a very arduous schedule when you think about how much she has been doing trying to manage the skating and her health. There's a lot of things to deal with, but right now she just has to stay settled in the ice. Then there's Maria Buterskaya. For her, really what she needs to do is just bend her knees and relax and not be so rigid on her feet, because what happens is she gets stiff and then she starts to fall off of the landings.
And Tara Lipinski is going to show us the world champion that she truly is. She really almost has no competition here. She's so focused. She's here to defend her title, and I'm sure she's going to do it.
And a quick recap of where we stand. The American champ is on top, the five-time Russian champion in second, and the three-time German champ in third. That's quite a lineup. Remember last season, Tara exploded onto the scene, reaching the medal ceremony of every competition she entered. Along the way, she raised the technical standard. As Susie Wynn explains, it was destiny.
It was pretty clear during her not-so-long-ago childhood that Tara Lipinski was born to perform. She just couldn't wait for these days to come.
To me, it feels like a long time since I was, you know, starting at three. It felt like forever to get to this point and to get to Worlds and everything. So to me, I felt like it was almost time to get there and do it. And, you know, I felt like when I was younger, I was always a performer. I loved to skate. I loved to smile when I was doing well. And I just feel the same way, and I don't think about it that much. So it just kind of happens.
It seemed to come so easily last year, but in her first event in this year's series, she finished second to U.S. rival Michelle Kwan. Then at Skate France, she again finished second to someone she should have beaten. Tara quickly learned the challenge of staying on top.
This year, I've been second in both my competitions, so I feel like I've gotten to that level where I can go after it more and be more motivated. And so I feel almost like the underdog right now, and I feel really confident with my skating.
Tara was the underdog last year, and look at all that she achieved. Now known as Miss Youngest Everything, the underdog role is one she enjoys.
From last year to this year, my experience with the competing and, you know, believing in myself and going out there and facing, you know, the fear and the nerves and saying that I can do this, I think that's the biggest thing that helped me from last year to this year, and I feel really confident going out on the ice to compete now.
In an Olympic year, skaters find themselves under the microscope more than ever. Regardless of age, the key to survival is obtaining a certain level of maturity and being able to handle the media's scrutiny.
Well, sometimes it's hard, and you just have to sit there and think, you know, how lucky you are to have your skating and everything you love, and you had a bad night, but you know eventually you'll get back up there. Mm-hmm. So that's what you just have to think about. Mm-hmm.
Does it ever make you, does it ever just tick you off sometimes?
Well, I mean, mostly it's my skating that I'll get mad at if I feel like I could have done better. But, you know, you have to just say it happens and you can, you know, go up from there.
With her positive outlook, Tara continues to travel down the path to success, led by her personality, talent, and desire. She has only one more piece of unfinished business.
I felt a little relaxed because I won the Worlds, I won Nationals. I kind of got that, you know, over the hill almost. And, you know, the years before I was thinking, oh, what happens if I don't do it this year? This is my dream, you know, part of my dream. So I almost feel a little more relaxed. And there's only one more thing I want to do.
What's that?
To win the Olympics. There you go.
Fellow American Michelle Kwan shares the same dream, and she promises to be set for Nationals and certainly the Games. Arina Slutskaya of Russia. In 1996, she became the first Russian lady to ever win Europeans, and then she repeated in 97. However, last week, she was fourth at Russian Nationals. Although she is still in the running for the Olympics, the Champion Series final here tonight will weigh heavily into that decision, along with Europeans in January.
A little sluggish. Let's see if she can be strong in this performance.
The jump that's been giving her a little trouble this week is a triple lutz.
No trouble there.
Single sow cow. Definitely she wanted a triple. Like that. Triple loop around the corner.
I'd like to see her work a little bit more on pointing her toes and her turnout. That's where we see such a difference between Tara and Michelle and Irina. But you can't beat her jumping ability.
Thank you.
But Dorothy, I think she's got some of that spark back.
She absolutely has. It's nice to see that performance.
She admitted she's been exhausted as well. Must be a sense of relief.
Here's her lutz. She has a very unusual takeoff. She really blocks her shoulder. She doesn't use her upper body as much to propel her in the air. She did a little bit in this one, which is why she did it so well.
And she is a little strategist also, for here's the first attempt at the triple salchow. Well, that didn't work out so well, so hey, I think I'll just back it up with another shot at it. And this one worked. Smart.
Always a fighter.
Late in the program, she does a very clean, nice triple loop. Just shows what a great athlete, great jumper she is.
The marks for Arina Slutskaya.
Well, Peter, I think those are pretty low. I mean, technically, she did a lot.
I have to agree with you, especially 5.3 from the Japanese judge.
I don't really understand that. Her spins were good. She's not happy. And artistically, well, you know, I have to agree with that. Maybe not quite that low, but she's the first one to skate.
Another chapter in the Tanya Shevchenko story next. Miracle on ice. It's certainly the right time of the year.
Happy New Year's. Here's to a great 98.
Munich, best known around the world for Oktoberfest. The shopping isn't bad any time of year. Any one of the top three can win it. Although Maria Butyrskaya has been notoriously unpredictable. We have seen a whole new Maria this season. She's solid second place finishes in the series. She won the Russian national title last week. New coach, new programs, new attitude. She shows up for all the practices, and it shows.
Does have their favorite jump.
pressure, but you managed to pull out of it.
Certain expression to ladies figure skating that none of the others have.
And that performance could put the pressure on Tara Lipinski.
Unfortunately, though, she did have a little stumble, not a major error. She has really stepped up her skating. It is stronger than it was last year, Dorothy.
Absolutely, it is. She seems to be in much better condition this year. Obviously been working hard. Here's a triple south cow. She really hurls her body. She's so tilted in the air. She managed not to fall, but she did have a 2-foot landing.
And here, this is just so natural for her to do a nice triple loop like that and then follow it up with a double toe loop. Good timing, very solid. And then this triple toe loop, that was fine, but look at this little double, the little strange step she takes out of that. That's unfortunate.
Didn't have enough speed. Couldn't quite pull out the landing on that. She kept rotating.
And a little mistakes. How did it affect her technical scores?
From 5.4 up to 5.6.
Fairly low marks, but she did have a few mistakes.
A little higher than Slutskaya. Presentation. Wow, how about that?
5.9. She must be happy with that.
Germany's own Tanya Shevchenko, and what an amazing story she is. Wasn't that long ago she wondered if she would ever skate again. And who could have believed she would be competing with the best ladies in the world? It was just a faint hope.
I'm amazed after last night that she's even out here tonight. I really thought she was going to collapse at the end of the short program.
triple lutz and just nails it with a double turn at the end.
That was beautiful. I've got goosebumps.
And keep in mind that Tanya was third in Japan after the short program. She came back to win that. If that doesn't bring tears to your eyes, what does? Well, we know what the audience thinks. We'll see how the judges feel when we come back from Kowa. Back with you in Germany. This program was just beautiful.
Well, it really goes beyond just the greatness in the jumps. The fact that she did this was just totally a personal triumph.
Beautiful triple loop. I don't know what to say. I'm in tears here. I know you are too, Peter. That was one of the most incredible things I've ever seen. Look at the height on that jump.
Fantastic.
Scores for technical merit, the crowd once more.
Wow. From 5-6 up to 5-8. I don't think it's about the marks at this point. It's really about the fact that this young lady really made the biggest comeback.
You're absolutely right. It's not about the marks. It's the greatest performance I've seen.
It's a difficult program to follow up. Tara Lipinski has her work cut out for her. She is one of America's gold medal hopefuls. And perhaps she likes playing the role of the underdog, and rather than being on top, maybe this suits her.
Nails those.
watch Tara Lipinski. You just kind of go into overdrive with her on these tough jumps. Look at this triple lutz. Double toe. She's got a smile from ear to ear.
I am so impressed with this young lady. I had a chance to tour with her last summer. She never missed a jump. She was out there practicing constantly. She's a really tough little cookie.
People expect perfection. They seem to forget that she's had to deal with growing 2 inches in just 1 year.
Doing her thing. Wow.
Just recently named the U.S. Olympic Committee's Women Athlete of the Year for good reason.
I don't think you could ask for much more drama than to just see two back-to-back performances like Tanya Shevchenko and Tara Lipinski. Here, the triple lutz. She gets good height on this and then settles right down to do a nice double toe loop. She's got great knees. The timing is exactly right.
Watch this triple loop, triple loop. You have to land with your foot in front and not fall and jump immediately to do another triple loop. That's incredible. That is so difficult to do.
Tell me about it. Not many men can do it. And again, she just follows through. Because she is so sure of herself with absolutely great practice habits, Tara Lipinski can produce that.
And this will tell the story, her marks for technical merit.
Wow, 5.9, 5.9. That's pretty good.
These are all very solid marks and much deserved.
Really given her the stamp of approval for the presentation. She's really come a long way in that department since last year.
The pressure was on, and Tara Lipinski stood up to it. Tara takes the title, but winning comes in many forms. Susie is backstage with Tanya.
Tanya, you made me cry tonight. And what were you feeling when you were at the end of your program?
I screamed really loud, and I'm happy that the ring is so big, and hopefully nobody heard me because I screamed, ah! Because I couldn't believe it. I didn't know what I can do, so I screamed everything out. So I screamed just.
Were they tears of joy or tears of relief?
Tears of everything, I think.
Best wishes. We love watching you skate. Congratulations.
Thank you.
A dream come true. Here are the ladies' final standings. The Russians still up in the air in terms of who goes to the Olympics for them. As for Tara, a nice boost of confidence heading into the national championships. Here's Susie again.
What a way to end 97 on such a high note, Tara.
It felt great. I mean, going out there, I feel like I'm, you know, here again, and I'm back, and I won last year, and it's the best Christmas gift I could ever ask for.
Were you at all distracted by the German ovation for Tanya Shevchenko? It was very loud.
Yeah, I mean, all the skaters, I think, skate great. I didn't watch, but I knew. Mm-hmm. And so it was a little difficult, but I wanted to do it. I said, I'm not going to let anything get in the way, so.
Does this build great momentum going into the U.S. Nationals?
It feels great. I mean, now I have the confidence in my short and the long, so I feel great.
Oh, congratulations. Thanks. All the best to you, sweetheart.
We're back for more Christmas Eve for what promises to be a launch fest. The top men in the world try to jump to the top. And we'll highlight the drama and creativity of dance. These couples can fly. It all happens at 8 Eastern and Pacific Time Christmas Eve.
If you want to see technical perfection in pair skating, you need only look to Bereshnaya and Sikarulidze, a prince and princess on the ice.
And what a glorious victory for this courageous young lady. She captured the silver medal, and she certainly won our hearts.
And the American still reigns. For Dorothy Hamill, Peter Carruthers, Susie Wynn, and our entire crew, I'm Susie Kalber, so long from Munich.